So Carrie Fox, thank you for joining us on Inside Your Library. And can you tell us a little bit about your role at the Seattle Public Library and how long you've been with the organization?
Sure. Thank you, Brian. And thanks for having me. Thank you for this opportunity. I'm happy to be here. I'm an adult services librarian and I work in mobile services. I have been with the library for 16 years. 15 of those have, in fact, been with mobile services. Mobile works out of the Community Engagement Services Department at the Downtown Library. We provide outreach and access to library materials for Seattle residents who cannot reach their libraries.
And when you say cannot reach the libraries, what does that mean?
People who have barriers to easily using the library, people for reasons of age or disability or low income may not easily access the library.
Carrie, how did you become a mobile services librarian?
Well, Brian, I frankly fell into it. I became involved in librarianship because I feel very passionate about intellectual freedom and free and equal access to information for everyone in our community. And I got involved with mobile services really early in my library career and immediately saw it as a way to improve access to people in the community without the same resources, and a way to really deeply engage with those people in the community. It's been enormously rewarding. There are places that I've been visiting for 15 years, and there are individuals in those places that I've known for all of that time. You get close with some of your patrons. I know everybody does throughout the library system, and that aspect of it has really been a gift. When I started, I was something of a youngster, and I didn't have a lot of connection with older adults in the community, and you know, like a lot of young people, they were maybe a little bit invisible to me. And I now absolutely love working with older adults and couldn't imagine doing anything different.
And how do you go about delivering the program to the public? Is it like through, most people probably think of the bookmobile, is that it?
Absolutely. That is what people think of most of the time. And we do have one of those, a bookmobile, which is exactly what you think of. What we do is we have 8 staff who are dedicated to supporting mobile services, but we really couldn't do what we do without the support of the entire library. And we do have staff from other departments who rotate through and come out on bookmobile runs with us. You'll hear me using bookmobile and mobile services kind of interchangeably, and I'll try to explain that a little bit more in just a moment. We have 4 vehicles plus a mail program. 2 of those vehicles in our fleet we use to haul book carts, which are actually like rolling bookshelves that we bring inside of facilities while we visit for people to browse, and we kind of set up a mini library inside for people. We also have a van that we use for deliveries. And then we have that bookmobile, which is just what you picture with stairs going inside and bookshelves, and it's a library on wheels. We usually have 2 of those vehicles on the road every weekday.
And typically, how many people benefit from this program, or how many people do you visit every month?
We visit 3,000 to 4,000 people every month, and that's at 120 different locations. But that encompasses our home service and our books by mail as well. You might be surprised to know that we check out more items than some of the smaller branches in the library system. So we actually do a bit more business than Madrona and about twice as much as New Holly, although it's not a competition.
So when we think that the library really has 27 branches, including Central, it's really more like 28 when you count the bookmobile.
In a sense. I just wanted to add, while I'm in competitive mode, we also happen to rank 10th out of those 27 locations in circulating non-English language books. And for us, that's mostly Russian, Spanish, and Vietnamese.
So Carrie, can you tell us about the program, the people that you see in the program?
Sure. We see 3,000 to 4,000 people each month at 120 different locations. The people that we see are preschool age children and their teachers, older adults, and people with disabilities. We do visit many low-income buildings where there's a lot of intersection with age and disability. We tailor how we serve our patrons to best meet their needs and meet them where they are with 6 different styles of service. We have that walk-on bookmobile, which is designed to serve preschool-age children. It's pretty neat. There are bins of books that are right at kid level with the front of the books facing out so they can flip through and choose books on their own to take back to their classrooms. And then we have a mail program and home service program, which are to deliver materials to people in private homes. We make deposits to group homes to be shared by residents and used to support activities there. And we go room to room in nursing homes where people cannot leave their rooms easily. And then we have lobby service, which is like a mini library set up in a shared space of a retirement home or affordable housing building. And that's where we bring those rolling book carts in with the shelves. And we choose the books to go out. There's everything from peak picks to mostly popular reading. And about half of what we bring is in large print.
And how do you determine that selection? Is it just a librarian selection of books that come out, or can people request the types of books that they want to receive?
People can definitely request the books that they receive. We'll bring holds out just like you could go into your neighborhood branch and pick up your holds. We'll bring your holds to you.
Oh, that's great. I bet you people love that service.
They're excited to see us when we show up, let me tell you.
Great. So the library is strongly committed to centering equity in its work and eliminating barriers to access for people. So, you know, given this focus, how has mobile services adapted over time to help the library achieve some of its equity goals?
Well, I would first say that the investment made in mobile services really highlights the library's commitment to these principles, and that's because of our focus on working with people with the greatest barriers to access, barriers like age, disability, and income. But going way back, the library primarily used the bookmobile program to go into neighborhoods where there were no branch libraries. But even then, we were striving to reach people with additional barriers to access. For example, back in 1931, the bookmobile had a stop at Boeing in order to serve shift workers there, and we visited children in orphanages. By the 1950s, we were delivering books to women at the county jail. And then in the early 1970s, we began to move away from traditional bookmobile service and adapt our service for adults to prioritize older adults and people with disabilities. We did this by creating home service and by going room to room in nursing homes. These are two services that we continue today. We carried that further with lobby service, which is that rolling bookshelf model that I talked about. With lobby service, we recognize that climbing in and out of a bookmobile is not accessible for many older adults and people with disabilities, so we bring the library inside. And then more recently, even more recently, we're centering equity by promoting our books by mail program in neighborhoods with the most seniors of color. And by updating our criteria for preschools to receive service, we're meeting our goals of reaching children from low-income families, children of color, and kids with disabilities.
So just out of curiosity, if somebody wanted to obtain their books by mail, how do they do that?
Well, initially, they just need to contact the library. They can do that through their branch library or by calling Quick Information. And they'll get referred to us where we'll have a chat with them on the phone and basically just talk about their needs. And we'll register them for the service. We have a short application that we send out to them to get started.
So it sounds pretty simple.
We try to make it as simple as possible.
So Carrie, the library partners with many organizations in the community. Tell me about the community partnerships that mobile services builds.
Every retirement home we visit and low-income housing community and childcare center that we visit with each month is really a partner. We rely on them and their parent organizations like Seattle Housing Authority and Seattle Public Schools for our success and for meeting the needs of their residents, their children, and families that they serve as well. Recently, through equity work, we confirmed that we were not seeing as many seniors of color in the retirement homes we visit as we would like. And this is for a variety of reasons. Elders in communities of color often live in multi-generational households, and to reach them, we needed to partner with the places where they gather outside the home. One such place is Club Bamboo. It's hosted by ACRS, the Asian Counseling and Referral Service. And Club Bamboo is a meal and social space for older adults in the Vietnamese community. We have library staff who speak Vietnamese, who curate a collection of books and DVDs, and they bring them there once a month for a visit. We found that as a result, our Vietnamese collection is circulating more than ever before. And the presence of mobile services in conjunction with ESL classes and citizenship classes has really raised the profile of the library in the local Vietnamese community. And my colleague tells me that when he's out and about going to the grocery store, going to church, people approach him and talk to him about the library now.
Great, that must be pretty rewarding to see. Tell us about some of the challenges in delivering mobile services. Like, how do you do this work? Do you have, you know, these big carts, I just can imagine them, you know, being pushed into a lobby of a retirement center. So tell us about some of the challenges in your work.
You bet. I will talk about those carts. people might be surprised by how much prep work actually goes into getting these vehicles prepped and ready to go out every day. For each day that I'm out on one of the vehicles, I have a corresponding day in the office. I'm doing things like placing holds for people who have a standing order with us. In mobile, we place over 20,000 holds annually, which is second only to Central. I'm also doing things like preparing collections for the trucks. So I'm pulling those books to go out on those book carts and also to fill the shelves of the bookmobile. I'm also registering people for services like Books by Mail, like we talked about. And I'm planning programs like our one-on-one tech help for mobile patrons. But this ends up being a really nice mix, because as you alluded to, it can be pretty physical work. Those book carts that we bring into lobby service are 300 pounds when they're fully loaded. So if you know, add a little rain and an uneven sidewalk into the mix, it can get kind of tricky. But we have a really great team, which is really critical, because it can also be like having an 8-hour road trip with your colleagues every day.
Sounds like you really love your job, and your team does too.
They're the best.
Great. Can you share a story about how your program has impacted some of our Seattle neighbors?
Sure. I have a couple of small stories I'd like to share. One of which is about a foundation funded program that we've been running for the past 3 years. And that is to loan iPads with instruction optional to low income seniors to help them improve their digital literacy and to increase access and connection. And let me tell you, people love their iPads and they often can't wait to show me what they've been doing with them over the previous month. A couple of my favorites are one gentleman who shared pictures of his family with me from the Philippines after reconnecting with them on social media, and a woman who's been using her iPad to rediscover her passions for photography and politics, and sometimes both of them at once. But I really love it when our work brings people and generations together, as in those examples. One of my favorite stops is an assisted living facility that I've personally been visiting for 15 years. And at that site, they have a childcare center as well. And so we bring books for preschoolers too. And so it's really neat. During our visit, the older residents are browsing around, checking out books and DVDs, and the kids are excitedly digging through the tote of picture books. And then the magic really happens when one of the seniors starts to read to the kids and a spontaneous story time breaks out.
That's great. I mean, those are types of services. Like, maybe we should start renaming the bookmobile to the iPad mobile based on how people like it.
Some people feel that way about it. Some people might also call it the hotspot mobile.
Oh, great. So those are the Wi-Fi hotspots that you distribute as well?
Yes. People can reserve those just like they could through the regular hold system, and we'll bring them out to them.
So many options for services that you can get through the bookmobile, thanks to Seattle Public Library. Well, Carrie, I think I speak for all of our viewers when I say that we are grateful for the connection and bond between the librarians and all the people of Seattle who see your faces and benefit from the work you do. So thank you for that. It's been such a pleasure to chat with you, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Brian.